Hello, good morning students. See, you have completed your post-midterm exam. Okay, so now today we will start one new lesson and that lesson name is Convention and Flame. Okay, so Convention and Flame, in this lesson, which points we are going to discuss? In short, you just listen. Okay, so first in this period we will learn about what is convention. Some combustible substances, then which substances are essential for the combustion, some non-combustible substances. Okay, so now first we will see the convention means what. See, what is a convention? See, many things you see around us, okay, big candle, matchstick. So what, see, convention means what? Those things burn. Okay, convention means what? The things which burn. So burning process is known as a convention. Means in scientific, in science, for the burn, that particular word, the another word it is given, that is a convention. So in short, you have understood about a convention. So convention means what? The burning process. Okay, so now as you have learned in the previous classes also, okay, we have done activity also, that candle, and if you will put the inverted glass on that candle, then what will happen? Okay, so see, for the convention, for burning process, what is important, what is very important, and that is present in our surrounding, good, oxygen. Okay, so for convention process, what is important? That is a oxygen. See, what is the property of oxygen? Oxygen support burning. Okay, so anything, if you want to burn it, so for that very essential component, that is a oxygen. Oxygen is very important for burning process and for convention. Okay, so which are a combustible substance? Now combustible substances means what? Those burn easily in air. Okay, those the things which burn easily in air, that all the substances are known as a combustible substances. Okay, so combustion means what? The burning process. See, here I have written the definition, that is a chemical process in which a substance burn in oxygen to give off heat and light. See here, this two words are important, that is heat and light, and this one is a oxygen, because without oxygen nothing will burn, the combustion will not happen. Okay, in the absence of oxygen, combustion will not happen. So oxygen is very important in this process. So anything burns, candle is burning, okay, so for that what is important? Oxygen is important. If oxygen is present, then only any substance can burn. See, in the last year also we have done practical, that is of magnesium ribbon. Okay, magnesium ribbon burn with a white flame. Okay, so what, when any substance is burned, it gives off heat and light. So that white flame means what? It light. Okay, so it, when any substance burn, it produces heat and light, and this process is known as a convention. Okay, but here it is a chemical process. Now why it is a chemical process? Because while burning, while combustion, the chemical reactions takes place, new substance is formed, so it is known as a chemical process. Now for example, suppose any substance, see, now Mg means magnesium ribbon with oxygen, what it will form? Magnesium oxide. Okay, so this is a chemical reaction. So chemical process is essential. Chemical process, like burning any substance, then it forms a new substance, that is heat and light, and this process is a chemical process. Okay, So what is a combustion? A chemical process in which a substance in oxygen, means in the presence of oxygen, because without oxygen combustion will not happen, okay? And it gives off heat and light and is called as a combustion. For example, this is Mg plus O2, MgO, magnesium oxide is a new substance form. So combustion means one chemical process. Now do you understand why it is a chemical process? Because chemical reaction takes place and new substance is formed, and without oxygen combustion is not possible. So do you understand about combustion? Okay, now we will see some more examples. Now for example, see here, some substances are combustible substances and some substances are non-combustible substances. Now combustion is scientific word for the burning process, okay? So combustible substances means what? Those substances burn easily in air, okay? That substances are known as a combustible substance. See here, the substances that burn easily in air to produce heat and light, okay, are called as a combustible substances. Now see here, some pictures it is given, that is candle burn, so it is a combustible substance. Paper is also burn in the presence of oxygen, so it is also combustible substance. Then wood is also combustible substance. And see, all fuels, now in the last lesson we have discussed about fuels, so you know that all fuels also combustible substances. And coal is also combustible substance, okay? So these are some example of combustible substances, means those burn easily in air to produce heat and light, are called as a combustible substances. Do you understand combustible substances means what? Okay, good. Now see, in the opposite, that is a non-combustible substances. So what is the definition of non-combustible substances? See, the substances that do not burn in air, see here, this is do not burn in air, are called as a non-combustible substances. Example, stone, glass, okay. The substances which do not burn in air are called as a non-combustible substances. For example, stone, glass, then iron, okay, these are examples of non-combustible substances. So today, at least, what is a process of combustion and combustible substance, non-combustible substance, maybe you have understood, okay? So these points, after this lecture, just write down in your chemistry notebook. And here some few examples I have given, that is a combustible is wood, paper, coal, and non-combustible stone and glass. But one homework for you, at least write 5 to 6 examples of each, that is combustible and non-combustible substances, in your chemistry notebook. Make properly 2 columns, combustible substances, non-combustible substances, and write examples in your notebook. Okay, now next point we will continue in our next lecture. So thank you.